Situated at Santacruz in Mumbai, this residential apartment stands out as a bright example of forward-looking architecture. Backed by a client who was ready to go the whole hog, architect Kayzad Shroff took the challenge that putting up an engineered facade of the kind would offer.
Client wanted, I don't want to use the word iconic, but he wanted a building that would stand out in its context. A building that would sort of reflect his personality of being a young builder who wants to sort of build, you know, work up his own brand. He was wanting a building which would sort of look forward, look to the future, not just in terms of, you know, color, but even materiality, method of construction, etc. And that is why we thought of using a product which is not that commonly used in India, at least as of now. It's a product which does not require a lot of maintenance. It's a product which does not require it weathers pretty well. From what we understand, it's even very eco-friendly. It comes with its own set of joinery, so you don't have to sort of work on, you know, creating details. It comes with a set of, it's like a Lego set. And we felt that kind of a construction system can allow you to build a facade, a system which looks engineered. It's obviously a very engineered building. The structure had come up a long time ago, but the engineering of the facade, where you had multiple layers of zinc, you had fundamax, you then had floor to ceiling sliding windows, sliding folding windows, all that to fit within, you know, just a 3.5-4 inch wall section, did end up posing a lot of challenges. And it's something that we had to work very closely with the facade consultant and with a lot of cooperation from the client. This kind of a system not only takes time, it takes more energy, money. Construction, if you had used the traditional method of building, would have probably been over a year ago. But the client supported us and was wanting a building which would speak about his vision of going forward.
A beautiful enigma was created by working out a non-repetitive pattern on the facade.
One important element for us was that even though it has repetitive floor plates, we wanted to create an envelope that will sort of hide what's happening at the back. It does not just hide, but not reflect exactly what's happening at the back. So even though you have the exact same floor plate, repeated floor after floor after floor, the system that we created allows for flexibility within the facade itself. And that's why you don't have a repetitive, you don't have a repetitive set of windows, you don't have a repetitive set of like solid elements within the facade. It's all staggered, because of which you get a varied feel, and it does not give you the very traditional looking building facade.
76 Avenue was a very small project, but it was interesting. It had many elements in it, like zinc, fundamax, it had French doors, and all of them were at different levels. So we had to plan that facade in a way that we could achieve the requirement of the architect by maintaining the different levels in the different, even zinc was in two shades. So to get the correct elements, different sizes of sheets and different levels, that was very challenging in the project. Also, it was the compound was very small, so it gave us very little space to execute the project. And then we had an element of sunshade that came as well. And if you look at the drawings, everything is in a, it's not going linear. They are all, you know, on every floor there is an offset between the different elements. So it was very critical to work out every element of the correct size to go in the correct place to achieve the project the way it is.
Mumbai offered its own set of challenges in terms of FSI and height restrictions.
First thing is your floor plate should be, your FSI should be maximized. No developer here is going to allow you to waste even 10 square feet per floor plate for aesthetic reasons. In addition to that, the plan needs to be extremely efficient. By that I mean there should not be any wasted corridors, no nooks and crannies, which are not really usable but therefore FSI reasons. What we started off with, see, it's a very small plot, right? We had only a permissible setback. We had a permissible setback, which led to a particular area of floor plate. We also had a particular height restriction that we could not go above. So keeping all this in mind, it is a very, very, very tight sort of project to work on. We were very clear that we did not want a building with protrusions. For a plot of this size and a building of this scale, for it to sort of have any sort of architectural relevance, it needed to be a clear form. We did not want elements which were jutting out for ducts. We didn't want elements which are jutting out for rooms, for kitchen, for toilets. We did not want all that. So what we did was we created an envelope, a rectangular envelope, and we played within the envelope, keeping in mind the regulations for duct sizes. Duct sizes have a particular permissible size based on the toilet that is abutting. So we played with the toilet size and the duct size based on the width of the duct also, keeping the overall area and perimeter in mind to allow for maximum usage of the area.
We use Suco system in providing sliding folding doors and French doors. Now, the doors being about 9 feet in height, a person would fall out from there, so we had to provide a railing. And to avoid any disturbance in the view when the doors are open, we provided a seamless railing system over there where there's only a channel at the bottom and there are no vertical balusters. Also to reduce, given the size of the windows and the clear glass that is used to avoid the sunlight coming in, we provided sun shades which are about 600 depth above every door. So that cuts in the amount of sun and glare that comes into the building.
The whole team behind the 76 South Avenue building faced the challenges head on, and that paid dividends in the form of a very admirable architecture in the end.